Welcome to another Audible article from MindPower, CenterPoint's free weekly email newsletter. Every Monday, MindPower brings you inspirational articles from leaders in the personal development field, useful tips and techniques to improve your life, plus CenterPoint news and updates. See the links below for more information about this week's MindPower. This week's article is Sacred Spacing, the Secret to Coming to Terms with and Finally Healing Trauma. Written and read by Marc Gilson. Sacred spacing is the act of creating a space for mindfulness and self-care. This means a literal place and time where the usual daily worries and concerns are shelved in order for us to paraphrase Timothy Leary, tune out and tune in. Think of it as a daily mental health break, a time for you and only you to simply sit and be present to whatever thoughts, feelings, and sensations that may arise. A few precious moments to yourself, for yourself, where you stop all you're doing and just practice being. The act of creating this sacred space is, as far as I'm concerned, the single best technique for mental, emotional, and spiritual health there is. It's easy, it's free, and anyone can do it. After over 25 years of coaching, I've encouraged countless thousands of people to implement this sacred spacing technique, with results that have astounded even me. How such a simple thing can have such a dramatic and lasting impact on people's health and happiness is still something of a mystery to me. But I've only needed a few thousand positive results to prove to me that it works wonders. So, how do you do this sacred spacing thing? Well, I'll tell you in just a moment. But first, I need to bring up another word, a difficult and heavy word. The word is trauma. Most of us at some point in our lives will endure some kind of trauma. Maybe, like me, you've experienced the sudden loss of a loved one. Perhaps you've endured abuse or cruel treatment at the hands of someone you once trusted. Maybe you witnessed some form of violence or lived through a war or a natural disaster. Even experiences we might think of as more mundane or commonplace, like a breakup, the loss of a beloved pet, the loss of a job or a social circle, these kinds of experiences can leave us with after effects that are, in varying degrees, traumatic. Trauma is one of the most difficult of life's challenges, especially when we decide we want to heal it. Now, why am I bringing up such an unhappy and thorny problem like trauma? Well, it's not to bring our mood down. I bring it up because I believe trauma is a much more pervasive issue than most of us realize. More people suffer in silence than reach out for help. Trauma can leave us with feelings of shame, guilt, confusion, feelings that we often repress and hide from others, and sometimes even from ourselves. And it's more important than ever that we shine a spotlight on trauma now that we've spent 2 years in a pandemic, what researchers are calling the most traumatic event in human history. Because the truth is, trauma is something that people try to avoid acknowledging, especially in themselves. They hide it, deny it, avoid it, and who can blame them? But unless you acknowledge that unresolved trauma is playing a role in your life, you'll never really be able to heal. If you're wondering why your relationships are so challenging, why your self-esteem seems so fragile, or why you're stuck in patterns of thinking and acting that aren't helping you live a happy and fulfilling life, there may be a kernel of trauma at the core. But if you only take one thing away from this article today, I want it to be this. There is hope. And it all starts with sitting down and being still. That's sacred spacing. Okay, let me be honest with you. Sitting down for a few minutes and creating your sacred space is not going to heal your trauma overnight. But if you make it a habit, work it into your daily routine, you will see results. I promise. So, let's get started. Step number one, plan it. Now, don't just plop yourself down on the sofa and wait. Get your mind on board. Remind yourself that what you're doing is important. Plan a time and space where you can sit still, undisturbed, in a very quiet place. Maybe this is in your bedroom or living room. Maybe it's a coat closet. One client I know practices his sacred spacing in his bathroom because it's quiet and has a door that locks. Perfect. Pick your spot carefully, though. This needs to be a place where you can tune the world out. So, don't sit in front of your TV or your laptop. Don't sit at your kitchen table with a pile of bills in front of you. Find a neutral spot, a place where there's nothing to distract you. Silence that phone. If you want to include some candles or soft lighting in your space, great. Take time to set it up properly. Find a comfortable seat, or perhaps set some comfortable cushions on the floor to sit on. You don't have to set a specific time limit for your sacred spacing, but I suggest starting with about 10 minutes. You can set a timer if you wish, but be sure not to sit there staring at a clock. Remember that your mindset is important. Setting aside this time should be approached with a feeling of reverence. This time and space you are allocating has immense value for you. It's a special place where there are no constraints to behave or to feel a certain way. Respect this space for the value it holds for you. Make it a truly sacred space. Step number 2, do it. I say do it, but sacred spacing is more about not doing. Put on some comfortable clothing, settle into your spot, take 3 or 4 deep breaths. You can count to 5 on the inhale and 7 on the exhale if you wish. Close your eyes and settle into the stillness of the moment. You can try to clear your mind, but the truth is you will very likely find yourself with a wide range of thoughts. Sometimes worries or silly things or what you might want to eat for dinner. That's okay. Just sit and watch for a while. If your knee itches, scratch it. Then relax again into the moment. Sacred spacing is simply about directing your awareness to the openness of the space you've created for yourself. Notice that space. Be a part of the space. Enjoy the simple experience of being still and calm. Step number 3, do it again tomorrow. This one speaks for itself. The benefits of sacred spacing come from consistency. Make it a habit. Prioritize this tiny slice of time out of your day and watch yourself become calmer, happier, more centered, and confident. Sacred spacing provides some much-needed relief from the excess stress that arises from unresolved trauma. And there's an even better, more complete solution out there for those who really want to heal more permanently. We just launched a brand new HoloSync suite, designed specifically to help you heal from trauma safely and effectively. It's called Total Trauma Relief, and it works by empowering your brain in 3 key ways. First, calming your hyper-aroused red alert brain. Second, raising your brain's tolerance for stress. And third, releasing repressed trauma. We also include instant access to coaching, so you don't have to face your trauma alone. Click the link in the description to learn more. Use Total Trauma Relief in your sacred space and watch your growth and healing blossom. Thanks for listening. If you enjoyed this article, please like, subscribe, and share. Until next time, be well.